Subscribe and click on the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest videos.
Hi, I'm Chinmayi. I'm shooting for JFW magazine today. I don't know what made me tweet, but life after the tweet has been interesting, I guess, to say the least. I've had various reactions to it, but what I feel gratified for the most is that there are a lot of women and men who have come forward with stories of being abused, molested, raped as children, and how they still don't have the courage in them to speak up about the perpetrators who sometimes lurk around in their own families, and them having have to deal with and navigate those relationships and interact with them as if nothing happened on a daily basis. I think that has been, I did not expect an outpouring of so many stories coming my way. That has actually been a very, very heavy burden to carry around. The burden, I'm not complaining, but the weight, the collective weight of these stories, and the fact that it makes me feel sometimes useless, that I'm not able to do anything more, and that I'm not able to correct something that's happening and has happened. And how do I tell these women and men to have the courage to call out their predators? I don't know. I really don't know. I wish I could do more. That this is politically motivated. I mean, women from across the left, far left, right, far right, center, mid-center, left of center, right of center, every woman and some men have spoken out about how they have faced their own predators. And today we have a minister from the government who's resigned finally. So, also giving a very casteist angle to this, that is specific to Tamil Nadu, I think. I don't think other women from across the country are facing that. But giving this a caste colour and giving this a political colour was what was strange. I did not expect that. But well, this tide has to be tided over. It comes from my husband, it comes from my parents-in-law, it comes from my mother, and it makes a huge difference. I understand when your partner in life stands right there and is giving you the support and strength, and also asking you, gives you a reality check on how, you know, to not become too emotional. It's difficult, you know, when you're reading all these stories and then you're having an emotional reaction to it. To stay calm and to still to control your anger, all that, it requires somebody to tell you with patience. I have been very impatient the past few days, impatient with a lot of things, and impatient with why aren't results happening immediately, why is this happening in society. All that angst is coming through, and you need a voice of reason which is telling you to, you know, take it a little easier and not take it so hard on yourself. So I think I derive my strength from Rahul. I derive my strength from all these women who have told me that they understand exactly what I'm going through. So I guess all the shaming comes from a certain group of men. I don't blame them. They have been they're conditioned to not have women stand up to their authority. So slowly things will change. before, it's the most positive support has been from women. It has been from men who say, yes, I believe you. You know, that one society has changed a lot, and I see how we have evolved to a point where victims are now told that, yes, we believe you, we stand with you in solidarity, we support you. So I guess to all these gentlemen, to all the ladies, all the girls and all the boys who understand, who know, who've been there, who have actually been through much, much worse than just have a man grope you without your consent, I, in solidarity with all of you, and thank you for all the solidarity that I have received. I had a great time shooting today, and I'm looking forward to the magazine, and I'm looking forward to the interview. It's been great doing this today.